Hi, this is Prithivi Raj from Bangalore, connecting with you once again through this message on will of God. It is told that the safest place in the entire world is in the will of God. Christian uses the word will of God more often than others. God creates everything with a purpose, and God has plan for his creatures. This means that God has a specific plan and will about each one of us. Will of God expresses his attribute of self-determination by which he acts in accordance with his eternal power and Godhead. Theologians distinguish between two types of will of God: decretive will of God and permissive will of God. Decretive will of God is the will of God by which God brings to pass whatsoever he decides. This is hidden to us until it happens. Permissive will of God is God's revealed law or commands, which we have the power to break, but not the right to break. Through the permissive will of God, he enjoins upon his creatures the duties that belong to them. The decretive will is always accomplished, while the permissive will of God is often disobeyed in earth. Entrance of sin in the world is attributed to the permissive will of God. It is God's nature to reveal himself and his purpose to mankind. God revealed the generic will about us in the written word of God. Some of the revealed will concerning us in Bible are that we thank him always, that we live sanctified lives, that we do good to others, that all people have the eternal life through faith in Christ. In Mark 3:35, Jesus said, "Whoever does God's will is my brother and sister and mother." And in Matthew 7:21, we read Jesus mentioning that doing the will of God is necessary for entering heaven. In the model prayer, when Jesus meant to pray for God's will be done on earth as it is in heaven, he refers to the permissive will of God, the execution of which is possible only when we make a decision to align our will with God's will. In Ephesians 5:17, we read, "Therefore, do not be foolish, but understand what the will of Lord is." And in John 7:17, we read, "If anyone chooses to do God's will." Doing the will of God starts with the choice we make to do the will of God. The willing will that wills God's will dwell within God's will. In many cases, our will contradicts with the will of God. The lust of flesh and the attractions of the world influence us to decide against the will of God. Other than the revealed will of God in Scripture, while making choices in our daily life, if there are right and wrong choices, we would go by the right choice. But while choosing from two or more right choices, or to choose from choices, outcome of which is not clear, we would face difficulty in finding the direction of God. God has blessed us with indwelling Holy Spirit, who teaches us, guides us, and directs our steps. He directs us in the will of God step by step. In order to gratify our desires, we quench the directions of Holy Spirit often. Responding to the promptings of inner voice in us will help us to be in the will of God. Faithfully obeying the revealed will of God, committing to regular study of Scripture, seeking the direction of God in prayer, godly counseling, etc., would enable us to walk in his will. Thank you for listening. God bless you.